Yo, 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 Service the Bear again with my second episode of Victorium. Last time we left off, we had just reached the vendor. And we were going to basically have a little look to see exactly what was there. Now, as you can see, there's a bit of a difference on the map already. We have got the Inquisition Legion already taking up most of these areas. So if I go to the end of them, it's going to be a bit of a pain in the ass. This kind of place reminds me of certain other games where you pretty much got to either boost yourself away across, or you pretty much risk it and try and hit as much as possible. So I'm gonna have a look at the vendor, see what they've got. I'm gonna full heal myself, I think, to be honest. Maybe. I don't know. So, 8 points of health. What else have you got here? Hungry Charge. How much essence? 15. Plate of Disappointment. Oh, yeah, why am I going to buy that? Other than that, physical resistance is 20 and magical thing. Everything else sucks big time. I think I might go with that. Hear ya. Come here. Generation one movement. See, that gives him more health. Okay, more health at moment in time. I'll keep a hold of that just now. What about this here? Ah, here you go. I can't afford them. What are your usual one ice spells?
I'm gonna stop for about 10 minutes. This is looking at your delicate eyes and you find your way.
Take that because I got projectiles. That'll be a spot here. Okay. Right, we've pretty much used all our stuff up. Let us move on. I'm gonna hastily bolt. Calm down, little man. Right, okay, so we are at Roltdale. Service Bear crunched through the forest, attracting the attention of two young people. Halcyon and her brother. Probably saying that wrong. Halcyon, I'll go with Halcyon maybe, approached him, clearly wary. Sir, I really hate to ask. Calm down, little man. I'm trying to do this here, bro. Alright? You're not being sidekicky here. You're being whiny kicky. Sir, I really hate to ask this of you, but please, a group of bandits have taken over Rolkdale. My brother and I are trying our best to live an honest life, and I don't have the capability of dealing with the bandits. I know you do. Please liberate Rolkdale. That doesn't sound right. Okay. So I either agree to help him. He was in the mood to deal with the wrath out upon the bandits, or ignored her pleas and pretty much went on. You know what? Fuck it. I'm always in the mood to whip somebody's ass, cause some damage, and be a complete pain in the butt. So we're gonna kick some bandits' butt.
You get some attention, huh?
Yeah. Can't keep that boy happy, can you? Oh, it's either treats, or something else. He's really addicted to some treats. I love the fact there's flying Christmas presents all over the place. Can I pick anything up from these guys? No? I hear you, man. Oh, you tried to use... That's a big hammer. I hear a voice. I hear a voice by... Oh, there. Ow, that hurt. I don't like being... So happy and cheerful and walking the zombies. Then again, when you think about that, I pretty much destroy buildings with ease. I'm not exactly somebody's best at that. Ah! There we go. It's always handy to find some help. Whoops. That whoops is an understatement.
I use the force. Excuse me.
Okay. Into a tavern we are. This time, don't try to blow up the tavern. Seriously, first of all.
Tavern tax man, give me all your stuff.
Wait, you have nothing?
Darn. I'll take your life instead. Die. I am Santa.
Flying Christmas parcel. Okay. Once he had routed the ruffians, Halcyon approached him again with a sack of essence. She and her brother had earned. Please take this as our thanks. We'll easily be able to earn more now that the marauders are taken care of. Cool, 16 essence. Continue the story. Alrighty. Moho. Servant of the Bear was not the only wizard in the world, and soon he stepped through the Nexus to Moho. He could tell that his destination had been altered to arrive at the home of Natamab. Natamba. There we go. Go with that. Natamba. An impressive wizard in her day. Now her power is waning. She spoke softly. It's a shame what happened to your order. I know of your goal, and while I wish you would not cause so much mayhem, your fate dictates you must. People do not need to die today. Here are the robes of the Moho mages. Wear them, and you should be able to sneak through undetected. Two options, of course. Servius scowled at the old woman. If the mages of Moho think they are a match for my power, let them test me. Servius the Bear took the old load to the moon and gave her a cautious nod and donned them to sneak through. With any luck, he could avoid more delays. What are you thinking? Bring him on. Test my skill.
Ooh, it's green. Green, lush. Nice. Pretty flowers.
Wandering through.
Nice.
Let's have a look here. What's this here? This would appear to be some sort of lumber place. Nothing really important. Flip. Do a bit of side motion there. Hop. This would appear to be some sort of outpost and some weaponry. Nobody's here. Nobody is at the inn. Nobody is home. Force the door open. Santa's here.
Nobody's home.
That disappoints me. I'm saddened. Santa, the only burglar that breaks into your house and leaves presents. A golden statue. Obviously. look pissed. Okay, we took a certain pummeling on that there. That's bad. Okay. Okay, I've opened up. I really seem like I need to find some health here. Oops.
all stuck in here.
Much
something.
Okay, so I suffered grievous wounds that day. Took more hits than a normal man would have been able to withstand. Killed everyone he could find with my rage. He came up with about 12 essence. So the gift bringer found a substantial amount of essence upon searching one of the fallen, showing that the danger had paid off. Okay, so we are now at the Menon Canyon. Signs placed throughout the Menon Canyon advertise the Dinder's Trinkets, a large trading post located at a short distance from the Nexus. Although Cerberus the Bear was loath to turn from his chosen path, it was worth stopping to see what could be had. So 19 health and 2 regeneration for 19 health, 2. Physical resistance 40 and 20 magical resistance. Thank you.
I don't have enough essence.
I have essence, but at least I've healed myself a bit more. It's fine. Let us move on. Okay, we're in Hare's Crook. Traveling through the densely wooded Hare's Crook, Service the Bear was approached by a short, slight woman in dark green leathers. You're that Factorum. Or Victorium, aren't you? My name is Neek Leafspringer, and I've been scouting a group of bandits set up in an encampment not too far ahead. They have been harassing my village for weeks, raiding our supplies, killing our livestock. Their numbers are too great for me to do anything about it, but would you make, you could make quick work of them. And again, two choices. The gift bringer was in a foul mood that morning and welcomed the chance to wreak havoc upon the deserving. Leave it to me. Or, shook his head, too many things to do to take a detour for all the problems in the world had. This problem is your only BBB. I'm going for the first one. Okay. Right, let's go. First lane. Oh, you got too close. Let's give this frostbite. Go.
No, calm down. Don't have a heart attack. A little health. See if there's anything else I can pick up. Nope. Okay, I'm liking the Frostbeard. Although I'm liking the... spell charging as well.
So far, things seem to be straightforward. Not too awkward. Heavers the Bear was fortunate. He was able to heal his wounds and continue his journey. Of course. I killed everyone I could find with such my rage. The bandits played Heron's Crook were routed, and the threat went to no one. Satisfied there was no remaining foes, Nick approached Service the Bear after the devastation and handed him a magical ring as a reward. Gives me 13 mana. Not too bad. Alright. And on that note, we are going to stop it there. I'm going to catch you later because now we have hoovering in the background. So I'm going to need to wait until that's done before I can get anything else recorded. I hope you enjoyed what you watched. If you liked it, like and subscribe to my channel. I know I don't always do regular things, but when I do, I will have them posted up as best as I can. Just all depends on my mood. Again, hope you enjoyed it, and I will catch you later. Bye-bye.